boy, you see, this is the plan of God. What did you say? God never made man to be alone. He never made woman to be alone. And I don't care whether you are intimate or whether you are husband and wife, amen, from the very beginning, when God said in Genesis 1 and 28, God blessed him. What did he bless? God made male and female. When men and women come together, amen, as brethren. Did y'all hear me? When men and women come together, preferring one another, able to be good to one another and to restore one another. When men and women, you ain't got to be married for this to work, because it's the image of God. Men and women are the fullness of God. The Bible said, and God blessed them, and he said, be fruitful. Now, when you read that, you think it's a husband and a wife. Amen. Yes, it can be. But I'm telling you now, when we come together as brethren, are y'all with me? What that word actually means is to make it fruitful, to make what you're doing fruitful, to make the business fruitful, to make the marriage fruitful. You have to make it when the man and the woman come together as brethren. Amen. What happens then? Now you can operate and you can cause that environment to become fruitful. You can cause that environment to multiply. You can cause that environment to be so fruitful and multiply till you got something left over. When you come together to work as brethren together, you got power one with the other. Where one's weak, the other one is strong. And now you got power to subdue a thing. And when you have enough power to subdue it, you can have dominion. Come on, thank the Lord in here. It was the Lord's plan, saints. From the very beginning, the church and the people that can operate. And I'm telling you now, it's not just marriage, although it can be. Men, male and female, is the image of God. Are y'all with me, saints of God? Glory to God. When we have the love as brethren, the Psalms and 133rd division tells us that we literally create an environment where God has to command the blessing and life forevermore. Even in the midst of this, God is commanding the blessing on the church, amen, that's fond of the brethren. He's commanding, amen, life forevermore. He's commanding the blessing. He said how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together. He's not saying brothers, amen, but brethren joined together, spiritually joined together. That's the place where God, he said, what happens is when you know it's like that, when you know it's God, amen, there ain't no big eyes and little U's. Whoever got it, you got it. Come on. It runs down from the top all the way to the bottom. It runs from the head all the way to the skirt. And it ain't a junior Holy Ghost. It ain't a junior anointing when it runs down. Hallelujah. How many know when something runs down, it picks up momentum? Come on, thank the Lord. Glory to God. Philadelphios, the church that prefers one another. Come on. Amen. The church. Glory to God. How many of you remember on the day of Pentecost? What happened? Glory to God. How did it start? If you remember in Acts 2 and 1, it says on the day of when the day of Pentecost finally came, what was the situation? They were in one accord in one place. 120 brethren. Understand, there were women there. All the Marys were there. Mary of Bethany, Mary Jesus' mama, Mary Magdalene, all of them were there. All of them. There wasn't just men. There were women. There were brethren, men and brethren, men and women, everybody. Amen. Glory to God. What happened? How? What happened? They created an environment that the Holy Ghost said, it's time. God said, it's time. And what happened? The Holy Ghost came down. And when the Holy Ghost came down, he was just looking for a little place. I'm looking for a few folk, amen, who will love one another. I'm looking for a few folk who won't just tolerate one another, but celebrate one another. I'm looking for some folks who know how to restore folks in the spirit of meekness. I'm looking for folks who will do good, especially to the household of faith. I'm looking for a few folk. I'm about to do a big thing, but it's going to start with a little thing. Come on, thank the Lord, saints of God. The Bible said when that happened, the Holy Ghost came down like a rushing wind. And what did he do? He began to do miracles, signs, and wonders. I got news for you, church. When we begin to prefer one another, when we begin to love one another, when we begin to think about one another, when we are good to one another, then the power of God, then the kingdom of God will be here. Give God a shout at this house. Hallelujah. You got a secret today. You got a mystery today. Look at the person sitting next to you. Can you believe that God just set you up for a miracle? Can you believe it? And you looking at the miracle right beside you. Did the devil messed up? He didn't know what was going to happen when he put Henry Crouch and Merv Massey together. What did you say? Are you out of your mind? Come on, give God a praise. You say, what you mean, preacher? Oh, now don't help me. Oh, let me help you remind you. How many remember Paul and Silas? The Bible said that they were walking about, and the woman was, and the little girl who was demonically, amen, it was, you know, she was saying the right thing, but it wasn't for the right reason. Amen. And Paul got tired of it. Paul said, come out of her. And when the demon came out, the girl couldn't do a thing no more. And not a man mad, because they didn't love her, didn't care nothing about her. All they was doing was using her. That's all they were doing. And what did Paul do? He delivered her and set her free. Come on, thank the Lord. Glory to God. I got news for you. There are some folk don't want you free, but I got news for you today. There's a breakthrough that's coming for you, and you better receive it right now. Right here, right now, in the name of Jesus, in the place where we prefer one another, in the place where we don't just tolerate you, but we celebrate you, in the place, oh my God, where's the joy to be good to you, the household of God. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, give God a thanks for your brethren and your sisters. Now they would have been all right if they'd have put Paul in a cell and put Silas in a cell. But they made a mistake. They didn't know how the works of God works. They put them in the cell together. Give God a praise now. Paul began to pray. Silas began to pray. Paul began to praise. Silas began to praise. The Bible says, at midnight, the darkest part of the night, it didn't matter because the brethren had come together and they created an environment for a miracle. The Bible says, at midnight, if you will love him, if you will love your brethren, if you will honor him in the name of Jesus, if you love the sister and honor her at midnight in your darkest hour, your breakthrough is about to take place. At midnight, the earthquake came, shook the foundation of the jail. You know it was God. How do you know it was God? If it was an earthquake, the doors could have opened. If it was an earthquake, the place could have shook. But how do you know it was God? Because the place shook. The foundation shook. But the shackles that were on men's feet, they fell off too. Give God a praise. Hallelujah. In the church where they're fond of the brethren, where they love as brethren, the shackles fall off. I don't care how deep you are. I don't care how far you've fallen. Hallelujah. We know how to reach way down because we remember when he picked us up. Give God a shout in this house. God says, I'm going to keep you in this hour of temptation. You ought to give him praise now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil didn't know what he did when he put them Francis and McGee's together. Come on, thank the Lord, saints of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The devil didn't have a clue. Huh? Are y'all hearing me, saints of God? When he put the masses and the Baileys together. Oh, somebody ought to give God a prayer. Hallelujah. Look to your left and look to your right. Say, the devil didn't know. But we know now. We got the secret. Go ahead and thank him now. Thank him, Robinson. Thank him, McClendon. Give God a praise in here. Thank him, Mungo. Hallelujah. Thank him, Massey. Thank him, Coffee. Come on, y'all all looking in. Come on, give God a praise out. Hallelujah. That's why we have parking lot. That's why we're in the house. That's why we're on the screen. For the love of the brethren, that none be lost. Give God a praise now. The Lord saying, I'm going to keep you in this hour. You ought to thank him in Jesus' name. Why are you thanking him? Thank him for your brother. Thank him for your pastor. Thank him for your elders. Thank him for your sister. Thank him for your brother. Thank him for your wife. Thank him for your husband. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In this hour, I'm going to keep you while everybody is falling. God's hand is on you. God's hand is on you. As your hand is on somebody else, God is blessing your hand. God is filling your hand. God is giving strength to your hand. Wave your hand and thank the Lord in this church. Hallelujah. 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 Your goodness has not been in vain.